Good morning, student. Today we discuss very important next topic, farm budgeting. This topic is very, very important topic in farm management. So try to understand it properly. And this topic is also very important for your final theory exam as well as for practical exam. Okay, so let's start with first slide. In this, we discuss first point, the expression of farm plan in monetary terms, that is by the estimation of receipts, expenses and net income, it's called farm budgeting. Underline this very, very important definition of farm budgeting, the expression of farm plan. Okay, when already I discussed in my earlier lecture about the farm planning. Okay. So farm plan, if you express that farm plan in monetary terms means you have to estimate here income, receipts means income, expenses, okay, in your farm, and net income. Net income means net profit. Okay, these three important points you explain in monetary terms, okay, in your farm business, then we can call that concept as a budgeting, farm budgeting. In other words, farm budgeting is a process of estimating cost, returns, and net profit of a farm or a particular enterprise. Now, farm budget are classified into three parts: enterprise budget, partial budget, and complete budget. Complete budget is also called as whole farm budget. Farm budgeting is a method of examining the profitability of alternative farm plans. So alternative farm plan means with available resources of the farmer, if you provide the farmer about different types of plans with maximum profit, okay, then we can call that plans as an alternative farm plan. Okay, so farm budgeting is very, very important method to analyze, okay, how many profit obtained by that farmer by using different types of alternative farm plan. Now, first we see first method or first type of farm budget, farm enterprise budget. Commodity production on the farm is called as farm enterprise. Whatever the commodity, okay, or crop produced on the farm, we can call it as a farm enterprise. Farm budget can be developed for each potential enterprise. Enterprise budgets are prepared in terms of a common unit like acre, per hectare, for a crop, one head of livestock, etc. For these points, you can prepare enterprise budget. This facilitates easy comparison among the enterprise. Enterprise budget is the estimation of expected income, cost and profit for an enterprise. For that purpose, we have to know about how to estimate the farm enterprise budget. Now, we see the next part, partial budgeting. Partial budgeting refers to estimating the outcome or income or returns for part of the business, that is one or a few activities. So note down this point, if we estimate any part, small part, okay, budget of any small part of the business or one or few activities in the business, then we call that concept as a partial budgeting. Partial budgeting is a statement of anticipated changes in cost, returns, and profitability for such a minor modification on the farm. When a farmer contemplates few modifications or minor changes in the existing organization of the farm business, partial budgeting technique is employed. Few modifications means minor changes if you have to done in your farm, then we can call that concept as a partial budget. We use that technique in that particular farm. Okay. It consists of how to estimate now partial budgeting. Already, we are going to see this part in your practical session also. But here you just know about the theory regarding this partial budget. It consists of four important elements, namely added cost, added returns, reduced returns, and reduced cost. Okay. Partial budget technique is generally used to evaluate the profitability of input substitution, enterprise substitution, and scale of operation. Already these two points we discussed in our, in what is input substitution, that is related with the factor-factor relationship, and enterprise substitution, this is related with the product-product relationship. So for both these relationships, you can use this partial budget technique. Okay, now first one, we see what is added cost. What is the meaning of added cost? Additional costs are incurred if the proposed modification is the introduction of new enterprise, okay, or increase in the size of existing enterprise. If you have to modify, then you have to incur some cost, okay, so that cost is called as additional cost. And what is the additional returns? Additional returns could be received when the proposed modification is the addition of new enterprise, okay, or increase in the size of existing enterprise, or adoption of technology that results in higher productivity. And due to this higher productivity, if your income increases, then we can note that income in added return parts. Okay, now what is mean by reduced returns? Reduced means decrease in the returns is observed when the proposed modification involves the elimination of an existing enterprise, a reduction in the size of existing enterprise. If you reduce the size of your enterprise, is it right? Then you can observe which type of returns, reduced returns. Okay, your returns goes on decreasing. And what is reduced cost? Decrease in the cost is found when the proposed modification involves in the elimination of existing enterprise, or reduction in the size of enterprise, or adoption of technology that use fewer amount of resources. So due to the use of less resources, you can observe which type of cost, decrease in cost. So these are the four important elements from which you can estimate partial budget. Which are the four important elements? Added cost, additional returns, reduced returns, and reduced cost. Okay, now we see the third type of farm budget, that is complete budgeting. It is a method of estimating expected income, expenses, and profits for the farm as a whole. Complete budgeting is employed when farmers wants to change or repair the entire farm business. If you have to change your entire farm business, enterprises in that farm, then you need to go for which type of budgeting? Complete budgeting. Okay. Now, very, very important next question, steps in farm planning and budgeting. This is also asked for your subjective questions in theory examination, enlist different steps in farm planning and budgeting. So you have to enlist all these steps. To make the farm plan successful, the following steps should be adopted with relevance to given farm and its resources. Number one, statement of objective. Diagnosis of the existing organization. Assessment of resource endowments on the farm. Identification of enterprises to be included. Preparation of enterprise budget. Identification of risk. And seventh step is preparation of a plan. So these are the seven steps. So we see in detail what you have to know about these seven steps. Number one, statement of objective. The objective of the farm may be profit maximization or cost minimization. This is very, very important objective of the farmer. In selecting enterprises and their combination, the farmer aims at maximization of profit. So this is the first you have to know when you plan or make any budget statement. Now, second point, diagnosis of the existing organization. Means what? Diagnosis and prescription are the two important components of planning. The planner has to examine the existing organization of farm business carefully and identify the weakness or defects or problems in the current plan. So this step is very important, identification of weakness or problems, defects. Once mistakes are identified, corrective steps can be taken in future. So farm plan primarily prescribes remedies for the defects of the existing plan. So for that purpose, we need this step number two. In step number three, we go for assessment of resource endowment on the farm. Resource endowments means how to manipulate the resources, availability of resources. In that, land is there, already you know which type of land you have to select. Then labor availability, okay? Then capital availability, working capital. In capital, two parts is there, working capital and fixed capital. Fixed capital, it is related with the fixed assets. For example, buildings, equipments, farm machineries. Is it right? Then organization. Organization means here farmer's knowledge, experience, confidence, adopting potential technology. We have to assess this point in resource endowments. Irrigation resources, sources, okay? Here period of availability of irrigation, which type of sources you use, okay? Crop demands, irrigation water, accessibility of land to the irrigation sources such as canal, tank, etc. So all these you have to know very well. You have to take the assessment of all these resources and then you have to make a plan. Now, identification of enterprises to be included. Here, list of enterprises not only grown by the farmer but also enterprise grown in that area and also crop rotations are identified. Estimate the input-output coefficients in terms of acre, hectare, or for our enterprise, which we propose to include. Information on input and output prices should be collected so as to work out the cost and return. So this is the identification of enterprise, which type of enterprise you have to grow, okay? Combinations, how to use that area. So this is very important in fourth step. And fifth step, preparation of enterprise budget. Means here you have to estimate income, cost and profit of each enterprise. Okay, that is mentioned in the plan. The preparation of enterprise budget facilitates comparison of profitability of different enterprise. Okay, for comparison profitability of different enterprise, you have to estimate the plan or prepare the enterprise budget. Then identification of risk. So you have to identify different types of risk like production risk, weather risk, technological risk, institutional risk, marketing risk faced by the farmer. Also, some of the risk due to pest, rodents, diseases, frequency of drought, cyclone, flood. It's also caused damage to the plant. Okay, marketing risk is very important where price fluctuation takes place. Failure of market. Okay. So, or is the malpractices of middlemen should be indicated. So, all these are the points you have to plan or make some budget in this step also, step number six. And with the help of all above six steps, you have to go for seven steps. Number seven, preparation of a plan. The first step is identifying the scarce resources, then selecting that enterprise which yield maximum returns per unit of scarce resource. Now, this process is repeated till all the scarce resources are put to the best use, which results in optimum combination of the resources or enterprise. So, these are the very important seven steps you have to know when you plan or budget your farm business. Okay, and the practical how to work out this partial budget and other complete budget, enterprise budget. These three examples we will going to see in our practical session. Okay, thank you.